Clearly.
Zico.
Alright, I'm Uwe Nielsen, I'm the MD of PM in Denmark. I'm going to talk a little bit about our new crossover unit for multi-layer labels. So, the unit is installed on this machine, and what we do step by step is first, we separate liner and top layer. That means that we will be printing on the new side, the back side of the label. And here we're printing a logo now, but this could also be a peel-off point for easy opening of the multi-layer label. After printing, we cure in a UV station, and then we re-lam the web so we have a normal web again. After that, we need to flip the web to have the front side upwards. Then we apply a special varnish. That means that we can separate the top layer and the lower layer from each other. So we apply a release varnish. When the release varnish has been applied, we enter the crossover section of the machine. In this section, we snip the web and move half of the web on top of the other half. Then we have a multi-layer label. The weight matrix is removed, and we then enter the normal die cutting station of the machine. After die cutting, we have a full working multi-layer label. I'm going to show you a quick example of how the job looks. This is just a test job, but a real job would have a matching top and bottom layout. But this is a normal web where we are demonstrating this, so I'll show you how it works. If you take a look here, we are printing flexographically on the back side. On the top side, we have a normal label, and now to open it, I have to attach it to something. So I'm going to put it on a table and attach it, so you can see. We actually have one here. I can open up. Here we have one side of the label. We have the adhesive side here, where we print it on. So you would have a logo here, typical front page, instructions here, multi-layer label. And also peel up this section. So it's easy to peel off in the corner where we remove the glue. And you can see our flexographically printed logo and the lower side of the label. This crossover section can be fitted to any of our DC330 converting lines. Alright, thank you.